As I was going to the fair in Dingle one fine morning last July, when going down the road before me, a red-haired girl I chanced to spy. I went off to her, said, "Aye, young lady, me donkey he will carry too." She looked at me, her eyes a twinkle, and cheeks they were a rosy hue. "Keep your hands off red-haired Mary, her and I are to be wed. We're seeing the priest this very morning, tonight we'll lie in the marriage bed." "Well, I thank you kindly, sir," she answered, then she tossed her bright red hair. "Seeing that you've got your donkey, I'll ride with you to the Dingle Fair." When we reached the fair at Dingle, I took her hand to say goodbye. A tinker man stepped up beside me, he struck me in my right eye. "Keep your hands off red-haired Mary, her and I are to be wed. We're seeing the priest this very morning, tonight we'll lie in the marriage bed." Now I was feeling kind of peevish, before all I was sad and sore. So I tapped him lightly with me hobnail, he fell back through Murphy's door. A policeman came around the corner, he told me I had broke the law. Me donkey kicked him in the ankle, he fell down and he broke his jaw. "Keep your hands off red-haired Mary, her and I are to be wed. We're seeing the priest this very morning, tonight we'll lie in the marriage bed." Now he went off to find his brother, the biggest man you ever did meet. He gently tapped me with his knuckles, I was minus two front teeth. This red-haired girl, she kept on smiling, "Young sir, I'll go with you instead. Forget the priest this very morning, tonight we'll lie in Murphy's shed." "Keep your hands off red-haired Mary, her and I are to be wed. We're seeing the priest this very morning, tonight we'll lie in the marriage bed." Through the Dingle Fair we rode,